Today we're going to talk about how to crease a derby car. A lot of people have been asking me this, and this is a widely discussed topic. There's a couple different methods to do it, but this is how I do mine. You guys can choose if you want to follow this idea or any of your own. Now what I'm going to do here is show you the differences of what we're going to be working with. Here's this fender of the car, right here. This is completely uncreased, no dents, nothing on it. What I want to get this side to look like, this back fender here, is just like this. As this side is mostly creased, I still have a little bit more to go on the bottom. But we're going to make the same exact pattern of creases on the driver's side. This is the passenger side of the Taurus. So, the first part of creasing a car is to have the right tools. Now, you could do this if you want with just any kind of hammer, and it will work out. But having different types of hammers and different weights of hammers will make it a lot easier. What I first usually start out with for creasing my car is this hammer right here, which is a lightweight hammer. Has a hollow metal tube. I don't know the actual weight rating on it, if it says. I don't think it's readable anymore. But just your standard light-duty hammer. Now, this one I will use to start getting the creases to shape on the car, just the very beginning of them. I'm using a light hammer because I do not want to hit the car too hard and bend it too far in real quick. I want to do it slowly so I can get my creases to shape. Otherwise, if you hit it really hard with a heavy hammer, you'll bend the whole fender and the spot you want to crease. You do not want to bend the spot to crease. As you saw over there on that side, we have a crease right up here along the top and a crease right here along that paint design. So what you're going to do is take your light hammer and hammer that in the middle, in between your creases, all along here. That's going to push this part down, but keep your two crease lines still raised up. So we'll just lightly hit that for now. As you can see there, we pushed in the middle. We're starting to get a little bit of an edge up top here. But this bottom paint line hasn't been in too far yet. If you could see here, when I hit this part, it actually bowed all the way down to there. So we're going to take our light hammer and pop this part back up into there in a bit. First, we want to get this part continuing on. Now, the second stage, after I will hammer some more on this and you actually get your creases formed, we'll be using a different hammer. And this is more of a heavy duty hammer. Some people will use ball peen hammers, others use a wedge hammer. I actually made my own hammer just for creasing. And that is this guy. It's a wedge style hammer. As you can see, it used to have a wooden handle. I replaced it with a solid metal bar. It's actually a sway bar off of a derby car. It's solid, very heavy. When you swing this, it will do some damage to the body. You will be making dents. I'm not going to show you it right now because I'm not further along on the creases, but what you will do with it is you're going to use that to hit above your crease and below your crease, and you're going to pinch that seam line using this wedge design. If you have a ball peen, some people use ball peen hammers on top and bottom. I actually have two ball peen hammers I use to pinch lines also. Just don't have them here right now with me. Now I'll show you with this other side how I use this wedge design. With the creases here, I would take the wedge and I would hit that right along this part, and also upside down, right along that part. And that's going to give you that really good pinched line on the top and bottom. Now, when you crease, you need to remember, as you crease, the body metal is getting tighter and tighter. If you over-crease a derby car, hitting it too hard, it will tear the metal. So as the body line gets stiffer, be careful not to hit too hard and stab and rip straight through the metal, or else you're going to just weaken the car. This line over here is pretty much maxed out. You cannot go any stiffer. It will start ripping the metal. So I'm going to go ahead and sit this camera down and work a little bit more on this fender to start getting the crease started. And you guys can see how it's turning out. Creasing does take some time if you want to do it professionally right. Take your time on it. Go ahead and monitor the car as you're doing it. And I think that fender over there probably took me about an hour to get that whole thing done. So we'll just do a short little bit of work on this and you can see how it's turning out. Let's hope the camera doesn't fall over and we'll be good to go. Alright, there we go. See if I can get some more done on that. Thank you. All right, I don't want to bore you guys too much by making you watch the whole process. But hopefully from that view, you could see it's definitely starting to shape out. I highly recommend when you are making creases, only doing one at a time. Because if you try doing both the bottom crease, the top crease, and the very, very bottom crease, they're all going to be fighting each other. So I'm going to do this top one first. When that one's done, I'll go on to do the next one and then work my way down from top to bottom. But as you can see, it's turning out very nice. I'm liking it. I use the light hammer to start shaping it and then the heavier hammer to start pinching it together on top and bottom. And once you start doing this to a car, you can tell the difference. Just run your hand across it. You can hear that in the echo. And that's a lot more stiffer. You can just feel it with your hand. Definitely makes a difference. So, hopefully we will get this side right here looking just like this side before too long. And that's just the trunk. Then I'm going to continue those creases all the way up the front of the car on both sides. Should turn out very nice when I'm done. I'll have an updated video when the whole thing is creased. So, hope that helped you guys out. If you have any other methods or styles of hammers you guys use, leave a comment below the video. I always like to hear different ways people do this for creasing. Or if you have a way that works better than mine, let me know.